I hear a voice on the phone like, call 911, and then that's it. And I'm just like, well, first of all, there's no 911 in China. But you know, I got the hint. Hi everyone, and welcome back to Road Less Traveled. If you are new here, thanks for coming along with us. If you don't know who it is, I'm Shelby, and I just make a bunch of travel videos trying to explore the world and inspire you to do the same as well, and overall just hopefully make this experience a lot more easier for you than it is for me. I don't normally do this whole sit down thing, but you know, when I'm in this seat, that probably means that I got a story time for you. And if you can tell by the title, it's a good one. You're not gonna miss it. So let's get right into it. But oh, first, hit the button down below. I know you see it, it's red. Subscribe, like, comment, share, do all that. It would really, really help. So okay, without further ado, let's get into it. This story happened right when I came to China. And if you didn't see my story time before about how I got punched in the face my first week in China, go click on that after this video or before, either or. But this story also happened in the same week. Crazy, right? I don't know why I still stayed, but. All right, so what happened was, if you don't know, I moved into China in August of 2017. I was going there for an internship for about 6 months in a public relations firm, and I was super nervous but also super excited. I came to China with a company that I won't name, and they basically helped me get to China and provided me with housing. I thought that I would have my own apartment. It wasn't meant to be, apparently, and I ended up with two male roommates, one of which was a white guy, I don't know if that matters, and the other a black guy. Both of them were American, and for the purposes of this video, the white guy, I'll call him Jack. His name is Jack, and the black guy's gonna be Devin. So okay, Jack and Devin, hopefully I can remember that. Jack, him and I, we didn't quite see eye to eye at all. So I kind of tried to stay out of his way because I wasn't feeling him. But Devin, he was super cool. We were, you know, we could vibe and you know why. But he was honestly super, super cool. And they were both here to do similar internships in China. So it was nice to be living with people that were like-minded. However, it was my first time living on my own and my first time living with two men. So I was like, I don't know. Anyways, we had different internships, and Devin, he had an internship at a restaurant, which was super, super cool. And this restaurant is super popular in Beijing, and it's called Migas, and it has two locations. If you ever go to Beijing, I highly recommend going to Migas. If you go to a place, Guomao, super famous, there's the huge, huge, I don't know, structure building. It's one of the things that you see if you see Beijing. And if you go to Migas, you can see it on the rooftop. It's so beautiful. He had an internship there, and we would often hang out when we had time. So one of the things about Devin that I noticed early on is he was super allergic. In my house, somehow there were animals. And that's a whole other thing. Somehow there were animals, and there were a few cats in the house, and Devin was allergic to cats. So that was one thing. He also was planning to stay there for just 6 months, and he had his EpiPens. And just to tell you how sensitive he was, he bought maybe like 6 to last 10 for the 6 months, and he already used 1 or 2 in the first couple weeks. So yeah, when we would go out to restaurants, he had like a really severe peanut allergy. So he would carry around a little card that would say like he's allergic, and he would ask like the waiter if there's any like peanut oil or anything in the food, because Chinese people, they'd be using peanut oil like it's nothing. So that's also something that I had to keep in mind, because if I was eating something with nuts or whatever, I can't offer it to him, you know? Let's get down to the nitty gritty now that you know the backstory of things. So one day he had told me that there was a party at the place that he was interning at, Amigas, right? I got home, I was already in bed going to sleep, right? All of a sudden, I wake up out of my sleep and I hear like footsteps in the house. So I just assume that it's Devin coming back from the party, right? And all of a sudden I hear a big boom. And I'm just like, what's that? But you know me rubbing my eyes and everything. I don't even know what it is. So all of a sudden I hear a voice on the phone like, call 911. And then that's it. And I'm just like, well, first of all, there's no 911 in China. But you know, I got the hint. So I get up out of my bed, I open up the door, and it's Devin laid out on the floor. And Jack also opened up his door because it was loud. So he's already passed out on the floor and like breathing super heavy. And I'm like, what the hell happened? And he's still conscious at this time, not really able to speak that much, but at least he was conscious. Jack actually tells me that he had eaten something with nuts at the party, right? Luckily, he had stabbed himself with the EpiPen right before he passed out, but even so, we need to do something with him. Jack is like, you need to come with us to the hospital, because luckily for me, I'm the only one who knows how to speak Chinese, and those two, well, Devin is on the floor, passed out, and Jack also doesn't know how to speak Chinese, so I had to go with them. All of a sudden, we have to pick up this guy. Mind you, Devin is like 6'3", mad heavy, and I'm just like, how are we gonna do this? So Jack gets on the other side, I get on the opposite side of him, and we're both literally dragging him out of the house. And we try to pick him up, but he's too freaking heavy for us, and he's literally dead weight. At one point, we get him up kinda, and then he's falling back onto the floor. And luckily for us, we lived on the first floor, so we just needed to open up the front door and kind of drag him out. But when I tell you, it was the longest process just to get him all the way to the door. We finally get him to the door, and he's falling. And at this point, he's eyes rolling back at his head, and he's not breathing. So I'm like freaking out. Thankfully, thank Jesus, our next door neighbor opens the door, and he so happens to be a surgeon, but they're kind of doctors, so I'm like, can you please help us? So our neighbor is literally in his boxers with no shirt on and no slippers, no nothing. He comes out into the hallway trying to help us get him, you know, situated. They tell me to go out to like our gate and try to talk to the security guard to try and call the ambulance and all this and that and the third. This guy is completely, at this point, stopped breathing. And I'm just like so thankful that eventually the ambulance was called and they were able to come and help him. And thankfully for him as well, he had stabbed himself with the EpiPen, so that was already like working, you know. He regained consciousness, and we had to call our the people who I guess brought us to China, the company. We had to call them, they had to come over, and it was just a whole big ordeal. He ended up going to the hospital for a little bit just so that they can check him up, but it was okay. But you know, when I tell you, that first week was crazy. From getting punched in the face and hit by a car, to my housemate almost dying, and I had to like quickly rush in that situation, use the Chinese that I did know, and try to help. Like, from those two situations, I thought China wasn't it for me. I gotta go home, I gotta go to my parents. But one thing that I can say that you should take away from this story, whoever's watching it, is there's going to be hardships in travel no matter what. But please, I implore you, don't let that take away from what brought you to that place in the first place. Not every place is for you, I know that. But travel is a sort of experience. It's a once in a lifetime thing, and it definitely changes you for the better. I know that if I would have left, I would have missed out on a whole bunch of opportunities. And thankfully, I didn't leave, because now I'm 3 years strong in China. And though currently right now the coronavirus outbreak is happening, I am itching to go back home. So, all right, guys, that's it for the story time. It was short, right? It wasn't that bad. Let me know if you like things like this and if you want more like sit down videos. I am happy to make them. In 2020, we got a lot planned for you. I promise I'm gonna be consistent in everything, all right? So don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, and all that jazz. And I'll see you later. Bye.